Welcome to the Hewlett Packard Enterprise Around the Storage Block video blog. I'm your host, HPE Storage Guy Calvin Zito.
Hey, at HPE Discover in Madrid, and we've had a ton of announcements here. One of the things I definitely wanted to cover was a new Apollo server. So, and I've got Chuck with me. Chuck, why don't you introduce yourself for a
minute? Sure. Hi, everyone. My name is Chuck Fang. I'm the Worldwide Product Manager for Apollo 4200.
So Apollo 4200. Apollo has traditionally always been an HPC product.
Yep.
This product is a storage product. Why is the Apollo 4200 Gen 10 a storage product?
Right, so this one is actually the most popular 2U 2P platform. So we have more storage than like the regular 2P. So we can store more data in the 2U form factor.
So give me a sense. This is the extended, so there's two rows of drives.
Yep.
We'll look at that in a second.
Yep.
How many drives can you support in one of these?
For the large form factor, we can support up to 28. And for the small form factor, we can support up to 54.
Okay, so depending on what the largest drive is at that point, what today is it, a 10 terabyte drive in the large or 12 terabyte?
We are actually supporting 12 terabyte at launch, so it's up to like 336 terabyte in a single, 2U space.
And tell me about like what some of the use cases are. I know we've got ISVs that are using it, like Scality and others, but what are the types of use cases?
Yeah, so we basically, this is very suitable for all the big data related solutions. So we basically focus on like software-defined storage or big data analytics. Some customers also use for like exchange or backup. So as long as you have the storage requirement, this one is actually very suitable for all these kind of applications.
Well, how about if we take a look inside real quick?
Sure.
So Chuck, what are we looking at here?
Yep. So we're looking for the front side of the 4200. So, on the front side, you can see it's a regular, like one row of the drives. But the spatial for the 4200, you can actually easier to do all the maintenance on front. So you can see the second row of the drives, you can come out. So customer in the rack level environment, they can do all drives hard swappable, and they can very easily to access to change, to exchange the drives.
All right, good. How about a little bit about what the compute is on a 4200?
Right, so you can see right after the system is actually the two rows of fan. So we provide enough thermal performance for all the cooling needs. So this is a regular two processor product. So we have up to 16 DIMM slots, so we can support up to 1 terabyte at the launch.
Okay.
And on the rear side will be the IO. So we have different rear cage to provide different storage capacity. So this is one of the new in Gen 10, which is a 6 NVMe SSD rear cage upgrade. So we can also support like 4 large form factor or another 2 small form factor with 2-4 high half-length PCIe for different kind of I/O needed.
Okay.
And we have 3 slot designed from each processor. So each processor has 1 slot for the controller to control all the drives, 1x16 slot to support up to 100 gigabit networking, and the 1x24 slot. It can help to handle the 6 NVMe. Each NVMe has 4x PCIe Gen 3, so we provide the full bandwidth for each NVMe. But without the NVMe support, you can use the x24 slots for, no matter whatever I/O you need.
Okay.
And we have the 2 power supply here for the redundancy. So in Gen 10, we can support up to 1600 watt for all the, all the power needed in the system. And we also have 2 1 gigabit here. It's like standard shipping. So the first port is actually the SharePoint. We can provide the management function. And we have 2 dedicated ILO manifold here. So we can do in the rack level environment, we can daisy chain up to save the infrastructure costs on customer's data center.
Okay, and again, given this is Gen 10, it has ILO 5.
Yes.
So all the benefits of ILO 5.
Yeah, see, it's actually the same as all the HPE management feature of the ILO 5, the OneView.
Yep.
So yeah, it's very easy for customer to use this product, the same as the other HPE servers.
Okay, great. Well, thanks for the time.
Thank you.
To learn more about this new storage server, go to hpe.com/storage/Apollo. If you've got any questions, you can always find me on Twitter as Calvin Zito. You can find our blog at hpe.com/storage/blog. Until next time, thanks for joining me.